Fans of heavy music are undoubtedly familiar with the work of the American group Hollywood Undead, formed in the mid-minus cards in Los Angeles and hiding their faces behind glasses, bandanas and masks with frightening prints. Since then, the band has released a number of studio albums in the genres of rap rock, new metal, crunkcore and alternative hip-hop and won the award for Best Crunk Rap Rock Group at the Rock on Request Awards. The first page in the history of Hollywood Undead was written on June 3, 2005 in a small apartment in Los Angeles.
It was written by musicians from the little-known garage band Three Tears Goose, Aaron Ehrlichman, Jay Gould, Joel Decker, JT, George Arthur Regan, and Charlie Sheen, Jordan Terrell, joined by Shady Jeff, Jeff Matthew Phillips, Funny Man, Dylan Peter Alvarez, D.A. Charles, Matthew Alexis Cusack, and The Phantasm, Justin LaFay Roman.
For the sake of their own pleasure, the guys recorded the song, The Kids, which received positive reviews on the international social network MySpace, and decided to continue to work together.
There was no need to search for musicians, since the composition of the new project included those who, during the recording, were in the room with the equipment and sang or played any instruments that came to hand.
The band got its name after J-Dog released a demo disc with the song Hollywood and with the word Undead written on the cover.
After reading this phrase in a different order, the team members decided that the phrase, translated as Hollywood Undead, reflected the creative intention and the original style as well as possible. The next stage in the formation of the group was the creation of a concert image, and the musicians decided to hide their faces behind frightening masks, bandanas and dark glasses.
Each participant came up with his own design, which, judging by the photographs, changed before the release of studio albums, and now the musicians have five different options in their arsenal.
J-Dog opted for light shades and wore white and beige hockey masks for performances with spots, bruises and a lip hole sealed with dollar bills. Charlie Sheen first wore sunglasses on top of a paper bag, and then covered the lower part of his face with bandanas with various designs and inscriptions.
A distinctive feature of Charlie Three Tears' image was the number 3, written on different parts of the mask, against the background of which were depicted the silhouette of flowing butterflies and elements of mosaics and crack paint.
The stage images of Funny Man, Shady Jeff and Danny, who appeared in 2008, looked less extravagant.
However, they were more than compensated for by the appearance of Juice, who later retained the impressive mask of the silver hockey player in his solo career, which began after the scandalous departure from the group in 2010.
Another musician to drop out of the original Hollywood Undead lineup is Shady Jeff. According to the official version, the vocalist left the band due to a change in commercial interests and religious beliefs, but, according to rumors, his departure was provoked by multiple conflicts with the singer, bass guitarist and keyboardist Deuce.
The rest of the members remained in the project, and now the group consists of Funny Man vocals, J-Dog vocals, bass, rhythm guitar and synthesizer, Charlie Sheen, lead guitar and vocals, Johnny Three Tears, vocals and bass guitar and Danny, synthesizer and vocals.
Curiously, Hollywood Undead never had a permanent drummer, and session musicians occupied the place behind the drum kit at various times. Hollywood Undead took the first steps in their professional career with the help of American singer and stylist Jeffree Star, who helped to make a video clip for the debut song and promoted the band on MySpace. As a result, after a year of hard work, the musicians composed the tracks for a full-length album and signed a contract with the recording studio A.
At Tony Records. Led by the producers who promoted Nine Inch Nails and Linkin Park, the band performed at the popular rock festival and sparked public interest in Swan Songs, featuring members' portraits and brand logo on the cover. Starting at the 22nd position of the Billboard 200 charts, the first brainchild of J-Dog and the company stayed there for 76 weeks, and thanks to a well-organized advertising campaign, sometime after its release, it received a commercial success, marked with a gold RIAA certificate. The singles, Undead and Yum, along with the song, Everywhere I Go, immediately became popular and in 2008 were used in the video games Madden NFL 09 and Rock Band 2.
At the Rock on Request Awards -2009, Hollywood Undead recognized the Best Crunk Rap Rock Group, and thanks to this, the musicians' agents were able to sell tickets for concerts and organize their debut tour. True, during the preparation process, disagreements arose in the group, and Dues, infected with star fever, demanded special privileges and refused to go on stage without a personal assistant.
The rest of the members, who had more modest requests, did not want to put up with the absurd character of their colleague and in a short time replaced him with a new vocalist, Daniel Morello, who later received the nickname Danny.
With the revamped lineup, Hollywood Undead played American gigs and began collecting material for the new album, American Tragedy.
Before the premiere in April 2011, the group released several singles online, including the hits, Hear Me Now and Coming Back Down.
The album turned out, soon after its release, it climbed to the top of the top hard rock albums rating and took the fourth place in the American charts. To further promote the album, the Hollywood Undead members embarked on an extended tour and performed with other alternative bands in Canada, Australia and Europe. There was no time left to work on new tracks, and in 2011 the band presented a disc with remixes of Levitate and other old songs, and then continued to tour with the programs World War IE and Buried Alive. During one of the concerts, Charlie Sheen announced that the group is still working on previously unreleased material, which should appear on the web in early 2013. Indeed, after the release of the singles, Dead Bite and We Are, fans heard the full version of the album, Notes from the Underground, which appeared on the internet a couple of days before the official release. The next work in the Hollywood Undead discography was the disc, Day of the Dead, which was released in parts in late 2013, early 2014, and then there was a lull in the band's work, and nothing new appeared for 3 years. It turned out that the members were solving personal problems and painstakingly working to change the style of music and the transition from crunk rock to metalcore and groove metal. The first sign that marked these innovations was the composition, California Dreaming, posted on the internet and later included in the album, 5. The E-Curls percussion and drums were absent in the record, which reached the second place in the American rating of alternative records, and soon from messages published on Instagram and other social networks, fans learned that the musician left the group and did not participate in the work on the compositions, Whatever It Takes, Nobody's Watching and Riot. The remaining 5 musicians continued their concert activities in support of the disc with the symbolic name and, as part of the world tour, visited such cities of Russia as Moscow, St. Petersburg, Yekaterinburg, Voronezh and Rostov-on-Don. Back in America, Hollywood Undead barricaded themselves in the studio and from May to November 2018 presented listeners with 5 new tracks from the mini-album called Psalms. In 2019, the compositions, Bloody Nose, Live Fast Die Young, Something to Believe, Gotta Let Go, and Another Level, along with other hits were performed at concerts in Russia, Belarus, Georgia and other countries located in Europe. Probably after the final performance, which took place on May 3 in Nottingham, the musicians decided to take a short vacation, and so far nothing is known about their future plans.
Smartwatch is not only a decoration or an element of an outfit, but also a personal assistant that makes life easier and motivates you to do sports. Smartwatches can help reduce the amount of unnecessary body movements. And you don't have to take your smartphone out of your pocket while driving or in a subway car to see who is calling you or who sent you a message on Twitter or Facebook. With this gadget, you will not miss an important call or reminder. You will be able to switch a music track on the smartphone player. And this is not all the useful features of a smartwatch. They are able to show the time, read your SMS messages, monitor your health, motivate you to play sports, and wake you up in the morning with care. No wonder these watches are called smart. We understand in detail what these modern gadgets have learned and what they can help us with. To be punctual. The watch is first of all about the time. However, the smartwatch screen is turned off most of the time to save power. Many watches have